Hey guys, well, seeing as the last video that I did where I compared the COD4 M16 to the MW3 M16, seeing as that got such good feedback, I thought that I'd continue this concept into a new series, which I've cleverly titled COD vs COD. And in this series, we'll take a look at some of the popular guns that have appeared in more than one Call of Duty game and decide which version is the better gun. Now, obviously, each COD game has slight differences, such as perks that affect the overall performance of the weapons in the game. So I'll not only be comparing the weapon statistics and in-game performance, but I'll also be looking at things like appearance in order to pick the winner. So in this episode of COD vs COD, we're going to be looking at the MP5, and we're going to be comparing the iconic COD4 MP5 to the most recent version in MW3. The MP5 from the original Modern Warfare is one of the most beloved weapons in the Call of Duty franchise. If you ask anyone who played Call of Duty back in the day, Call of Duty 4 back in the day, chances are they're going to speak pretty highly of this gun. When Infinity Ward announced that they were going to bring the MP5 back, many people in the Call of Duty community, including myself, were pretty excited. However, when the game came out, the MP5 that we got, while still fun to use, was definitely not the same gun. So as you probably know, the MP5 in MW3 was one of the guns that got buffed in a recent patch, and since then it has regained some of its former charm. But the question is it as good as the COD 4 version? When you compare the basic stats of the two guns side by side, you can see that the damage rate for both is pretty similar. However, when you take into consideration the stopping power perk, the COD 4 MP5 is clearly more powerful. And even, now this is going to get a little bit complicated, even when you subtract the 25% reduction in damage when the enemy has the Juggernaut perk equipped, it still comes out on top. Range is another area where the COD 4 MP5 beats out the MW3 MP5. Getting the exact range for the MW3 version was a bit difficult. There doesn't seem to be a whole bunch of information out there, so the figures that I've got were the most consistent I could find. So if you think they're wrong, please let me know, but as far as I could tell, these are pretty accurate. But even if they are off by a little bit, it's still clear that the COD 4 version is a winner by quite some margin. There's not a huge difference in the reload speeds, again leaning towards the COD 4 variant's favour, but as you can see, the COD 4 MP5 definitely has a slightly lower recoil. Now, there are a whole bunch of other stats that I haven't covered, including center speed and running speed and all that sort of stuff, and even going into more detail in the recoil patterns. And the reason I haven't is most of the other stats were pretty similar between both COD 4 and MW3, so there weren't really huge differences there, and therefore it didn't really factor into the overall score. So stats aside, one thing that I like to take into consideration when picking a gun is how it looks and sounds. Now, I know that this may seem pretty stupid to a lot of hardcore and pro players, but Call of Duty is a game after all, and it's definitely one of the things that I factor in when I pick a gun. So I thought it was worth working into the overall score in this versus series. On the surface, both guns are pretty similar, with only a few minor visual differences such as the stock and the grips. And although the MW3 version isn't a bad looking gun, I definitely think that the COD 4 version is the more attractive of the two. In terms of audio, obviously the game engine has seen a few modifications and improvements over the series, so the MW3 gun sounds, I think, overall sound a lot better than previous games, and therefore I think the MP5 in MW3 definitely has a more meaty sound than the COD 4 version. Now, I don't think it's miles better than the Call of Duty 4 sounds, but I definitely think if you had to pick one out of the two that it's the better sounding gun. You may disagree, of course, and I'll probably support your argument because I do think the COD version sounds good too. So, what gun is the winner? In my opinion, it's the COD 4 version by an absolute landslide. Statistically and visually, it's got the MW3 version beat. Now, that doesn't mean that the MW3 version isn't any good. It's still actually one of my favourite guns in MW3. Even after the most recent buff patch thing, it is still outclassed by a lot of other guns in the SMG class. It's still definitely one of my favourite guns and definitely worth using. So, I hope you enjoyed this episode of COD vs COD, and in the next episode, we'll be taking a look at one of the more controversial guns from the Call of Duty franchise, the FAMAS. And the two versions of the gun that we're going to be looking at is the MW2 Burst Fire version and the infamous Black Ops version. If you have a suggestion for a weapon you'd like me to cover, or for this series in general, just leave it in the comments below. If you'd like to know more about either of these two guns, then I've left a whole bunch of links to the various websites and forums in which I use to gather my information from. There's a whole bunch of people out there that go to great lengths to explain the different stats, figures, and other bits of information about these guns. So if there's absolutely anything that you want to know that I haven't covered, go and check them out because they are just crazy in detail. Anyway, that's about it. If you want to leave me a like, that'd be awesome. If you don't, that's all good. And I'll catch you guys later. All right, see ya.